Yeah, they are, but this needs a bit of more examination. That is, they are not more powerful in controlling public opinion by just having a kind of totalitarian TV, because then you have the opposite effect. If you have a kind of totalitarian control of mass media, where it is obvious to the people that what they hear is just a lie, then they don't bother. But here they have created this system I mentioned before of pseudo neutrality or pseudo objectivity that persuaded a lot of people that what the BBC says is right, is the truth, and so on. And we should not forget, and we come to the cultural and historical factors again, that Britain was, as a country, was on the side of the winners, on the side of those countries that were controlling other people. So as long as it was a colonial power and with significant power and so on, and later on it developed into the present state of affairs, the people were persuaded by the mass media easier because they have not developed any kind of mentality or reasons not to believe the mass media. For example, I remember that people, Irish people who live here in Britain, and I had a lot of discussion with them, they don't believe a word about what the BBC says. Now, they don't believe a word. Why? Because they start from their own experience and they know what sort of lies the BBC was saying. So they tell me why we should believe what they say about Iraq, etc. They tell the same lies. So this has to do, I think, with the cultural and historical factors I mentioned, which determine the kind of attitude that people have as regards the mass media and the authorities in general. Yeah, of course, no doubt about it. And the reason is, of course, that this way you can create a kind of people who actually believe that they are free and believe that they can do whatever they like, but in fact what they can do is what is very much controlled and restricted by the state, by the not only the state, by the elite in general. That is, you are free, of course, in the sense that even you can take drugs to some extent. This is not strictly controlled, or you are free to do whatever other recreational activities you like, and you are free within the market restrictions to do whatever you like with your enterprises and so on. So the impression has been created that there is a kind of individual freedom in the sense that people can do more or less what they like, but in terms of what I just described. And when now they face all this kind of surveillance we have and so on, they simply have been persuaded to accept all this for security reasons, as I said before. And they still believe, however, that we are better, we are freer than in the Soviet Union, or freer than in the Muslim world, or whatever. And therefore, since we are freer than all those people, that means that this is a free country. This is the kind of argument I think that most people accept, that because there is this facade, I would say, of freedom, facade of freedom of information, that you can buy any paper you like and so on, or you can watch hundreds of channels, even though all these channels and all these papers, in effect, reproduce the same kind of line with different versions. So people are not, do not have actually the neither the time, especially under the present conditions of survival, nor the will to start going deeper to see what exactly is the news we get in. That is it what actually happens in the world? Why they make this sort of comments, so on. But don't forget, the average citizen just works 8, 10 hours or whatever a day, and then has some hours to relax before he continues the same kind of hard job. So nobody reads apart from some very easy bestsellers which reproduce all this kind of cultural mentality we have at the moment, consumerism and the individualistic values and so on. So if anybody reads this kind of bestsellers, and if they go to the alternative, to the internet, they are bombarded with billions of bits of information which, unless you have the ability and the background to check which is important and which is not, you may end your life reading various kind of rubbish. So the internet is simply reproducing the same kind of rubbish that the mass media are doing at the moment. Therefore, this kind of regime, of course, is infinitely more effective than a totalitarian regime, and that's why it's much more difficult, in a sense, also to create the anti-systemic consciousness required so that people could understand what actually going on and try to overcome this kind of system.